Hello students, welcome back to Gyanmansha Vidyapeeth Online Education. Students, today we are going to continue this lesson from our supplementary reader snapshot. The title of this unit is Albert Einstein at School. Students, in the last video lecture we had discussed that Albert Einstein is very much upset, is very much sad because he doesn't want to go to school. The reason is he is interested in the topics and the field related ideas, thoughts and logic. But here is not interested to remember anything regarding the dates of history. And that's why the history teacher scolded him. So he becomes more upset because he was forced to go to school. He was not willing to go to school. And here the father is forcing to go to school and the history teacher denied to come to school. Now what to do? Even he doesn't wish to go to school, but what to do? That is the confusion. And that's why he thinks to take the help of his friend Yuri. Because he thought that suppose he's going to have any kind of brain stroke and suppose there is advice from the doctor that he cannot go to school, it would be more beneficial for him to take rest and not to go to school. And that's why he talks to his friend Yuri. Now it would be more interesting to see what's going to happen the next. So students, you may carry your supplementary reader snapshot with you. Let's see what happens the next, right? Suppose, said Albert, that I had a nervous breakdown. Suppose a doctor would say it's bad for me to go to school and I need to get right away from it. Means he's thinking that he has the solution of this problem. The problem is he is not willing to go to school. The teacher is not ready to accept him, but the father is forcing to go to school. So this is a problem, and now is going to find the solution of this problem. He thinks that suppose he has the kind of nervous breakdown and the doctor advises him, suppose the doctor suggests him to take rest only and not to go to school. So it would be more beneficial for him in his favor, so that this wish can be fulfilled, that not to go to school. I can't imagine a doctor saying that, Yuri. So it was a plan of Albert Einstein, right? He's thinking about all this thing that it can be the kind of solution and all. But is any doctor there that can be ready to give this kind of advice without any kind of problem? Because that's the kind of situation that doctor will not allow to do all these things. It's not proper way. It's not good way, I think. He thinks that doctor will not say, doctor will not agree, said Yuri. This is the ideology of Yuri. I must try, said Albert, to find a doctor who specializes in nerves. There are plenty of them, Yuri told him. He hesitated for a moment and then added, rather than reluctantly, I'll ask some of the students if they know one. If you like, will you? Oh, thank you, Yuri. Albert's eyes were shining. Now Yuri is thinking to take suggestion from the students, other students. It is possibility because they may having some kind of idea regarding this doctors and all, this ideas regarding medical field and all. So that's why Yuri is saying that we may take advice from other students as well. So it would be more beneficial for them because they are not aware about all these things. So that's why. When Albert Einstein listens all these things, he realizes that Yuri is that much interested in this matter of Einstein, and that's why he becomes very much happy. He says that he is very much happy and he shows, he presents the happiness towards Yuri, and that is shine inside his eyes because of happiness. Wait a moment, I haven't found one yet. Albert Einstein became very much happy. But Yuri told that, wait, let's find someone at least first, because right now we don't have anybody like this. Oh, but you will. And if I do, I don't know he'll be willing to help you. Einstein has faith on Yuri. He's emphasizing this matter that definitely you'll be able to find a particular one who can help us. So Yuri says that actually it's true that he'll definitely find the one who knows about this thing, but there is no surety that the person will be ready to help Einstein or not. Because to find out one person and to make that particular one to get ready for this help, this both the things are quite different. So that's why here Yuri is feeling quite hesitation that what will be happen the next. That's why. He will, declared Albert. I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown. To make it easier for him, he laughed merrily. Now here, this unit takes a different turn. Albert Einstein told that actually he's going to make nervous breakdown in real manner. Really, it is not fake, or it is not any kind of fraud, or it is not any kind of that thing that is not real. So to make that person work much more easier, Albert Einstein is even ready to have the real nervous breakdown. I have never seen you looking less nervous, remarked Yuri. A day or two at school will soon put that right, Albert assured him. That definitely you'll find me like that. Next line. Certainly he had lost his high spirits when Yuri saw him next. I can't stand it any longer, he said. I really shall have a nervous breakdown that will satisfy any doctor. I can't stand it any longer, he said. I really shall have a nervous breakdown that will satisfy any doctor. That if it is actual nervous breakdown, then it will not be any kind of requirement for this kind of drama and all this kind of convincement of the person and the people as well and the doctor as well. So if I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown, then the task will become much more easier for us. So this is the suggestion and the planning of Einstein. So what do you think, students? Will Albert Einstein be able to successful in this planning and all, or something else will be happened? Let's see. So to satisfy the doctors, is going to have real nervous breakdown. Keep it up then, said Yuri. I have found a doctor for you. You have? Albert's face lit up. Oh good, when can I see him? Now Yuri is speaking that Albert is that much confident, then it's okay, it's fine, then he's ready to help and is saying that he has actually found one doctor for Albert. And when Albert heard this thing that actually Yuri found a doctor for him, he becomes that much surprised, he becomes that much happy. And he asks, okay, did you really find the doctor for him? You have. Albert's face lit up. Oh good, when can I see him? Now he's very much excited to see the doctor. I have an appointment for you for tomorrow evening, Yuri said. Here is the address. So finally, the date of appointment is also fixed. And address is also given here. He handed Albert a piece of paper. Doctor Ernst Weil. Is he a specialist in nervous troubles? Asked Albert. Whether the person is specialist or not for nervous breakdown? Not exactly, Yuri admitted. As a matter of fact, he only qualified as a doctor last week. You may even be his first patient. Oh my God, that's quite risky. Einstein is asking that, is that fellow वेरी एक्सपीरियंस्ड क्वालिफाइड एंड स्पेशलिस्ट बट इट इज़ नॉट एनीथिंग लाइक दैट दैट पर्सन इज़ नॉट इवन दैट मच एक्सपीरियंस्ड एंड इट वॉज नॉट इवन स्पेशलिस्ट इज वेल बट ही वॉज क्वालिफाइड लास्ट वीक ऑनली सो ही हैज़ नो एक्सपीरियंस एंड मे बी there is possibility that Albert Einstein can be his first patient. So this thing is very much surprising and quite shocking as well, because now a person is not experienced and Albert is going to make this kind of experiment of nerves breakdown. So what will be happen the next? Will be there any kind of harm with Albert or something else will be there? You knew him as a student. Then I have known Ernst for years. Yuri hesitated for a few moments. He's not a fool, he warned Albert. What do you mean? Don't try to pull the wool over his eyes. That's all. Be frank with him, but don't pretend you have got what you haven't. Not that you'd deceive anyone, Yuri added. You are the world's worst liar. Yuri is explaining that actually you are very much bad at speaking lie. If you are going to speak lie, what do you think? Will you be able to deceive anyone? No. Don't pretend that you are having something that you actually haven't. So be honest and be frank with the doctor, because otherwise it can be very much harmful for you. And that's why he wants that he's not that fool man, the doctor is not that fool person that you think, and even Einstein is not good at speaking lie, so that's why speaking truth is the best option for him. Next paragraph, students. Albert spent the next day wondering what to tell the doctor. When the time arrived for his appointment, he had worried over it so much that he really was quite nervous. Next day, wondering what to tell the doctor, because he was not good at making excuses, he was not good at speaking lie. So naturally, he has to think a lot. He has to force the mind even a lot to convince the doctor that actually what he is saying, that's a real. And that's why he was wondering a lot what to tell the doctor. When the time arrived for his appointment, he had worried over it so much that he really was quite nervous. Actually, he wanted to pretend that he was nervous, but when it was the time of appointment, when he was about to meet, he was about to consult the doctor, he was about to talk with the doctor, making conversation like, so at that time he became really nervous. So it was now not the kind of drama, but right now he's actually nervous. I really know how, next page, students. I don't really know how to describe my trouble, Dr. Way, he began. Don't try, said the young doctor with a friendly smile. I don't really know how to describe my trouble. Means Einstein is actually, he doesn't know what to speak, and that's why he's speaking that I don't know what to say, I don't know how to describe my trouble. And see, what is the answer by this doctor? Don't try, said the young doctor with a friendly smile. Yuri has already given me a history of the case. That now it's not anything about to be worried, nothing about the stress and tension and all, because Yuri has already told me the history of this story and this case. Oh, what did he say? Only that you want me to think you have a nervous breakdown and say that you mustn't go back to that school. So ultimately he knows about this fact and all. So he's saying that Yuri has told me that you want me to tell that you have nervous breakdown and because you don't want to go to school. That's why this advice should be there from my side. Oh dear, Albert's face fell. He shouldn't have told you that. Why not? Isn't it true then? Yes, that's the trouble. Now you'll say there's nothing wrong with me and you'll tell me to go back to school. Albert said that yeah, actually this is the matter. When doctor asked that isn't it the portion of reality, isn't it real that I told you? Then Albert replies that of course yes, it is a part of reality. It is reality. But you know, now you know that I'm completely fine. I don't have any kind of nerves breakdown. And that's why you will not make that kind of thing that I wanted to make you. And again, I have to go to school that actually I don't like. Don't be too sure of that, said the doctor. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure that you are in a nervous state about that school. That doctor is replying. The doctor replied that I'm quite sure, I'm so sure that you are in a nervous state about that school. But I haven't told you anything about it, said Albert. Wait, how can you know that? That actually I haven't told you anything regarding my school. Then also, how can you say these things so surely, so confidently that I have some kind of a nervous state regarding my school? Because I haven't told you any kind of incidents, any kind of stories or my experiences with classmates, teachers and all. So how can you make this kind of assumption on which basis that I am in the nervous state regarding the school? Because you wouldn't have come to see me about this if you hadn't been pretty close to a nervous breakdown. Because you wouldn't have come to see me about this if you hadn't been pretty close to nervous breakdown. That's why now, said the doctor briskly, if I certify that you have had a nervous breakdown and must stay away from school for a while, what will you do? Now the doctor is replying that I could know because of your activity. Because suppose you were not in that kind of state, then you cannot arrive at my place, you cannot come to me. But you arrived, and that's why I can say that you are in. But suppose I even certify you that you want the kind of certificate that you are having nervous breakdown. Suppose I agree also with you, but what will you do if I certify you about this nervous breakdown? What will be your activity? What will be your actions afterwards, after this certificate? I'll go to Italy. See, this is the reply by Albert Einstein. I'll go to Italy, said Albert, to Milan, where my parents are. And what will you do there? Okay, you want to go to Italy. Albert replied that he want to go to Italy, but afterwards, what will you do there? I'll try to get into an Italian college or institute. I would like to join some Italian college or institute. How can you without a diploma? I'll ask my mathematics teacher to give me something about my work, and perhaps that will be enough. I've learnt all the maths they teach at school and a bit more, he added when Dr. Vale looked doubtful. That without any kind of diploma, how will you go to any kind of school, any kind of institute or college? You are not having that kind of qualification, no? That's why. Then Albert replied that my teacher, my mathematics teacher who was teaching me at my school time, so I have learned all those things that my maths teacher was teaching at school and even much more than even. So I think that will be sufficient for me because I'll be having some work over there. So this is the reply of Albert Einstein. And at this moment, this doctor looks at Albert very doubtfully, at Einstein very doubtfully. He thinks whether this conversation, whether this matter can be that much trustworthy or not. And that's why looks that doubtfully. It would be more interesting, students, to see that what is going to happen the next. One by one, the incidents are becoming that much interesting. So this unit, this lesson is becoming more interesting to understand and to study. So today we are ending up to this portion. Your today's homework is, what is the planning? This is the question, okay? You have to write the answer of this question, okay? So what is the planning of Urey and Einstein so that Einstein can avoid going to school, okay? Second question, that how is the response of the doctor towards Einstein? Next question, why did Einstein become very much happy and how did he react towards the doctor? Okay, so these three questions are there. You have to note down in your book. Okay, try to understand well. Suppose you find any kind of difficulty, then you are free to ask me anytime. Okay, take care of your health and thank you. Have a nice day.